We return to the Russian invasion of Ukraine. The tiny nation of Estonia shares a 180-mile border with Russia. During World War II, the Soviet Union occupied the country. And when the Soviet Union collapsed, Estonia regained its independence. Now it is a NATO and a European Union member on the front line facing Russia. For more on how it is responding to the war in Ukraine, I spoke with Estonia's Prime Minister, Kaja Kallas, earlier today.
Prime Minister Kallas, thank you very much for joining us. At the moment we're speaking, the Russian Defense Ministry is saying there will be significant military pullbacks in the north of Ukraine, around Kyiv and other areas. What do you make of this?
First of all, they haven't told the truth before, so we have to be very skeptical if they are telling the truth now. But if they are telling the truth, then it means that they are struggling because Ukrainians are fighting really, really hard. And they are assessing that they can't take Kyiv. But we must understand that if we look at the map, they have progressed in very many areas of Ukraine, and they have not, pulled back from Ukraine, so the aggression is still there.
What more at this point do you believe the West, NATO, can do to stop Vladimir Putin, to stop the Russian military, and especially to stop them from killing civilians?
First, we definitely have to help Ukraine with all the means that we can. Military aid, we can give them. We have given, as Estonia, a very small country, we have given a lot, over 200 million, which is for our 1.3 million people, a lot. But bigger countries can do more. Then, second, we must help Ukrainians with humanitarian aid and trying to get the civilians out. But on the other hand, we also must isolate Putin in every possible way in all the international fora, because what he is doing is clearly committing war crimes.
We had on the NewsHour last night a respected analyst tell us that he believes that this war could be morphing into something like the Bosnian War, which went on for 3 years, left over 100,000 people dead. Do you think that that's a real possibility?
Well, if we look at the surveys that have been done in Ukraine, then majority of Ukrainians believe that they are winning this war. And the other question that was posed to them was that should the war be stopped some territory should be left to Russia if they achieve peace? And again, majority said that no. So President Zelensky is in a very difficult position, because his people are thinking that they are winning this war, and the victory means that Russia pulls off completely from their territories. And until that time, they will fight. But at the same time, President Zelensky really wants to have peace, because he sees his people being slaughtered and his cities being destroyed.
I want to ask you, Prime Minister, about Estonia. Obviously, you're a much smaller country than Ukraine. Does what's going on there make you much more worried about what Vladimir Putin could do to your country and aimed at your people, many of whom in your east are Russian speaking?
Well, first of all, actually, exactly 18 years ago today, we joined NATO, and that makes a huge difference. No NATO country has ever been attacked. We don't see any military threat, and we feel secure. At the same time, we also discuss in NATO to, boost our defense, because if we have such an aggressive neighbor and is clearly invading neighboring countries, then our deterrence should be boosted up as well, because in order to have peace, you have to prepare for war.
And how many, let me ask you about that. I mean, how many more troops do you think need to be stationed in Estonia? How much more weaponry? How much of that would be troops from other NATO countries?
We feel that we should have in the Baltics combat ready division of NATO, of course, with the enablers, which means air defense and other capabilities. We are currently discussing at the NATO level, and the military is looking into that, because one is that we are ourselves investing a lot in our defense, almost 2.5% now, but also the other pillar is the collective defense of NATO. So we also have to spend this money wisely, which means that we have to cooperate more, procure some capabilities together that would be too expensive for any individual member state to do on their own.
Prime Minister, let me ask you about what President Biden said in the last few days, and that is that Vladimir Putin cannot, in his words, remain in power. Do you agree with him?
I think that Vladimir Putin has to be isolated politically on all the levels, because what we see in Ukraine, why there are more civilian casualties than there are military casualties, is because they are targeting the civilians, and this is a war crime. What I'm really worried about is that if some kind of agreement is made that Vladimir Putin is not, somehow liberated from all the responsibility, because if he is, then he will move and make additional moves later on. So we can't forget all the crimes that he has already committed in Ukraine.
What do you mean liberated from responsibility?
If the goal is to get a peace agreement, then what I mean is that this is not the end. We should not forget what he has already done to Ukrainian people. Because if we go back to business as usual with President Putin, then his appetite will only grow.
The sanctions that the West has imposed on Russia seem to be hitting the Russian people much harder than they are either Vladimir Putin or any of the people around him. Are they truly being effective?
We see that the sanctions work. Why else Putin is complaining about them and wants to, lift the sanctions or is talking about this. So definitely the sanctions hurt, and the sanctions should remain in place until, he is moving away from Ukraine, and also possibly paying for the war damages, the repairments for Ukraine. If we compare the sufferings of the Ukrainian people, it's incomparable what they are suffering to anything that is going on in Russia.
Final question, Prime Minister Kallas, and that is, as you watch the suffering of Ukrainian people day after day, as this war grinds on, how do you take that in as a human being? How do you take that in as a leader who is responsible for the Estonian people?
Yes, it's very difficult to watch, especially that we have had the same kind of faith. I mean, my mother was deported to Siberia when she was only 6 months old, together with my grandmother and great-grandmother in cattle wagons for 3 weeks. There are exactly the same crimes going on right now in Ukraine, and it's very, very difficult to watch. And what I've been advocating to other leaders of NATO is to give more military aid to Ukraine so that they can fight back, give you humanitarian aid. If we can do it for 1.3 million people, then bigger countries can do much, much more.
Prime Minister Kaja Kallas of Estonia, thank you very much. Thank you.